Let's take a look at the Incident Report task and what kind of information you can get from there. This task is located in the Investigations section of the homepage from the Security Desk. Make sure you're not confusing it with the Incidents task, even though they have the same icon. This task is used for another feature in Security Center that is not related to Mission Control. The Incident Report interface should look pretty familiar at this point. You have your incident list on top, with similar columns to what we're used to seeing in the Incident Monitoring task, the Details pane on the side, and the standard look for the report filters on the left. The main difference here is that the map has been replaced with a tile canvas. If you need to change the tile pattern, you can do so using the button on the bottom here, just like the Monitoring task. Using tiles means you can select multiple incidents to investigate and switch between them very quickly. The Details pane will update with the details of the incident in the tile that has been selected. In the Filters list, you can choose to filter based on the unique incident number or ID, the type of incident or name, and other incident properties. You can also choose the time frame from when it was triggered, either going back a certain amount of time until now, or a specific range of dates and times. You can also search based on the response and resolution times, including any TTR events that have not been respected. These will only be present if a limit was configured for an incident type. The last filter is for anyone who is creating incidents and is using the testing mode to see if they're working. These type of incidents do not normally show up in your incident list. Once you have set up the filters for the incidents you want to see, click on the Generate Report button on the bottom of the list. Note that below the filters, you also have a tab to see the area view. So if you need to watch video from a specific camera, you can drag it into a tile from the area view. Next to the Change Tile Pattern button, you also have a Synchronize Video button, so any cameras that are playing in tiles will all play from the same date and time. The Details pane also has the General tab so you can see the widgets for the type of entity you're looking at, like the camera or door controls. One important thing to note here is the list that's populated on top is a static list of incidents from when you clicked on the Generate Report button, and not a dynamic list like you see in the Incident Monitoring task. If you have filters set to only see new and in-progress incidents from within the last 2 days, and someone opens a new incident after you clicked on the Generate Report button, you won't see it added to the list until you hit Generate Report again. Once you have your list of incidents generated on top, you can drag them down into the tiles. The tile that's highlighted will show the details of that incident in the Details pane, and you can still interact with this incident. For active incidents, which are ones that are not in the closed state, you can do pretty much everything you can from the Incident Monitoring task. If you want to use the menu to do things like changing the state or forwarding to another user, you'll have to use the menu at the bottom of the Details pane. The right-click menu on the pin or list is not enabled in the report task, but the regular map functions are still present for map objects. For closed incidents, there's very little that you can do, and they're mostly used for review purposes. For example, you can add a comment in the latest activities section, link to a related incident, and attach a link to a document, but you're unable to do things like modify procedure steps, change the priority, or link a related entity. If you're less concerned about looking at individual incident details but want to see a summary of some information from it, you can change from the tile view to chart view. Click on the chart icon on the top right to go into chart view. The tile view icon is right next to it in case you want to go back to that view. Switching to the chart view will remove the tiles in the details pane and will give you a line chart of your top 10 total incidents by default. Use the top right menu to change the type of chart shown and the options next to it to configure specific settings for the chart. If your chart has more than one axis or sort criteria, you will see a drop-down menu where you can choose what to see for that axis or how to split up the totals and how many entries to show for it. For example, if I change my chart type to a stacked columns chart, my x-axis can show the different types of incidents and the y-axis can be my total. If I want to see more information, I can click on the Split By menu and choose Priority. Now I can see how many list entries I have for each incident type, and that total is broken down into the number in each priority. If you want to save the information you generated in the report, you can click on the Export Report button just above the list. This will not give you the details for the incidents, but everything you're looking at in the list you generated. If you have a chart showing, also known as a graph, you can choose to export the list data, the graph, or both using the checkboxes next to the options. You can also specify what format you want to use for the exported data and graph. For data, it's preferable to export in Excel or CSV format so you can open it and format the columns, but you can also do a quick PDF version from here too. The graph or chart can be saved in a JPEG or PNG format in case you want to include it in a presentation or report that you're preparing. You can also select the destination for the files and the name it will use for both. Click Export when you have the parameters set up to save the files. Next to the Export button on top, you can also print the list, or you can add the filtered report to one of your dashboards in different formats. In case you need to save all the details from a specific incident, you can export the individual incident from either the Incident Monitoring task or the Incident Report task. If you're in the Incident Monitoring task, select the incident to export and click on the menu icon, or right-click on the incident pin or incident in the list, and choose Export Incident. From the Incident Report, select the incident you want to export in the list, and click on the Export Incident button below the list. You can also use the Export menu option from the Details pane when the incident is selected in a tile. From the Export pop-up window, first you need to choose the name of the folder that will be created in the vault for this incident. It will use the incident name and ID as the default. When an incident is exported, it is saved as an XML format. This is fine for computers to read, but it's not very easy on the eyes for us humans. You can choose an additional format to use next, like PDF or HTML. If you'd like, you can also put everything into a zip file by checking the Compress Output option. If you do, you can say if you want to delete the source files after the zip file has been created, or encrypt the zip file with a password. In the Data section, you can select which pieces of information to export, like the map view, snapshots, and video files. The video export behaves the same way as a regular video export. You can adjust the date and time to start, and how long you want the video file to be. The cameras chosen in the related videos are any that are source entities or attached entities. Below the list of cameras, you can choose the file format. Some may take more time to process since it will need to encode the video in that format. Once you click on the Export button, you'll see the progress indicator in the system tray. This will notify you when the export is finished. A quick way to see the exported incident in the vault is to click on the Completed icon in the system tray, then choose Completed, click here for more info. This will show the exports that have been done. In the bottom of the window, click on Open the Vault to see all the files in your vault. The vault is a folder on your drive used as storage for exports by Security Center. If you want to copy the files you exported onto a USB key or network drive, right-click on a folder in the vault and choose Open in Windows Explorer. From the file browser that comes up, you can copy or manage files in your vault as much as you want. If you find you're constantly setting up and running the same reports using the same filters, you can save that configuration as a task. Think of it as a template for your report. If you keep the trigger time dynamic, like within the last 2 days, every time the report is brought up, you'll see the current information. To save a template, first set the filters the way you want them. You can generate a quick report just to make sure you're seeing what you expect. Next, right-click on the Incident Report Task tab on the top of the security desk. Select Save As, and you'll be able to choose if the task will be private or public, the destination folder for the task, and the name of the report. You can create a new folder using the button on the bottom left as well. Click Save, and your task will now show the name you gave it. You may have to hover on the tab to see the full name. Now you'll be able to bring up this report anytime you want by going to the home screen and choosing either private or public tasks, depending on how you saved it, and selecting the task. This report can now be used as part of an automatic schedule of tasks or sent to another user. If you make any changes and want those to be permanent for this type of report, don't forget to right-click on the tab and choose the Save option before closing it. In our homepage, you have one other report in the investigation section for Mission Control, and this is the profile report. You can select the profile you want to investigate, the initiator or who made the change, the recipient that was affected, and the modification time using the filters on the left. Click on the Generate Report button, and your list will populate with a list of any changes made to profile assignments. This is a way you can track who was assigned to a profile or what profile someone had at a certain time. Similar to the incident report, you can export or print this list, add the details to a dashboard, or view the list data as a chart or graph. You can select what kind of chart to use, and it can also be saved as part of the export. This concludes our four-part Mission Control Operator Training session. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope it was informative and you've learned everything you need to know to start handling incidents. If you take a look in the video description on YouTube, you'll find a link to a cheat sheet that you can print out and keep handy while you're working on Mission Control incidents. You can also find all the information from this video in the Genetech Mission Control User Guide, available from the GenetechTech.hub. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day.